and do something with your lives. You understand? You guys, this is your world.
What's that? Who's that?
Yo, pick up the phone.
Yo, do what I say.
What's up?
So what do you want? Jesus Christ, just spit it out.
How did you set yourself apart from your family members and, you know, go off kind of on your own path? What is your advice to make your mark in life, I guess?
It wasn't an intentional thing. It's just kind of like everybody got to this point where they wanted to do their own thing. Keenan had his vision for what he wanted to do. Damon had a vision for what he wanted to do. Sean wanted to do what Sean wanted to do. And I'm just sat there looking like, all right, well, I guess Marlon's gonna do what Marlon does. And I just started doing it. And I think over time, we'll figure out who I am. I don't know. I just know I love what I do. I know I love making people laugh. I know I'm fearless. I really don't really give a fuck. And I don't know if that's a gift or a curse, but I think that's my gift. If I had something to offer, I think that's just the way I live my life. That's just the way I present myself on stage, is because as bold as it may be of a statement, I think my intentions are always pure. So I think it's always gonna magnify something sweet and something that has a good overall message, because that's who I am as an individual. You know, I just want people to smile and laugh and enjoy life. So, but I think people think too much, and we gotta stop thinking and giving a fuck and being all sensitive and go enjoy life some.
Can I tell you a secret?
Sure, man.
I see dead people.
Man, this shit is awesome.
Yo, son, you gotta roll some more. That shit awesome.
So you also had a very big impact on the we'll call the spoof genre of movies.
Oh, yeah.
How do you kind of feel how it's changed from maybe when you guys first started this kind of new style of movies to kind of maybe where they are today?
They don't exist today. And part of that is because of, I think, YouTube and Instagrams, and, you know, because now, before you go, it takes a year to do a movie. It takes a year and a half to write a decent movie. It takes like at least, you know, 6 months to a year to write a decent movie. That's before you produce the film. And when you're doing movies like this, it's about pop culture. Pop culture is always shifting. And then it's about finding the right movies to parody, and it's about parodying a genre. And no genres are really sticking like they used to. And in YouTube, I think everybody does the bastardized version of what you would do that is funny before you even get to it. And so it just becomes tired and becomes stale. Comedy's hard, and we just make it look kind of easy. And so people's just like, oh, that's silly comedy. All right, bro, try it.